Hey guys, it's Ultraman Chronos again. Been a while since I posted a review. I'm sure you guys all heard about what happened. Computer kind of just shat out its brains and whatnot, and had to get a new one. But everything's working good now. Got all my stuff moved over, so now we commence with the typical reviews and whatnot. Falling a bit behind, but I think that's a good, because now we can extend this a little longer than normally. If I got every review done by now, it'd be like, okay, what's next? Alright, so back to the reviews. Today we're going to take a look at, of course, Zigra from the Gamera series. So I'm sure you guys have all seen a review or two of this figure before, so I'm going to try and keep it a little brief in certain areas, like history. Obviously, you know, Zigra appeared in the Gamera movie, Gamera vs. Zigra, yada yada yada. Alien, you know, shark from space. Well, that was kind of redundant, but you know. Comes to Earth, you know, fights Gamera, gets killed. That kind of thing. If you want a more extensive review, go and look at a few other people's reviews of the Gamera, you know, figures, particularly Zigra, of course. They go a little more in depth, like a few others. You guys know who I'm talking about. So yeah, we're gonna skip the history and just get right to the figure. This is the Morlocks figure, as you're aware, I'm sure. The original figure, it's a nice figure, I'll admit. Because, you know, it definitely looks a little more accurate in, you know, like, the feet area. But this one is overall the better figure, I would say. And, you know, the one I'm sure a lot more people are interested in, you know, getting. So, it's obviously from the Gamera Memorial Box. That's not the official name. It's just kind of, you know, kind of a fan name. We kind of just started calling it. But it doesn't really matter. Comes with, you know, tags and cards, all that good stuff. And, as usual, I forget the tags and cards. Now, this is obviously a 16 scale figure, just, you know, it's not going to scale up, you know, in the super accurate way. You know, Zigra would be a little taller than Gamera, as you can see. But, you know, that's really nitpicking, I think. It looks fine, and I think that's what's important. So, it's your typical, you know, 16 scale figure. Looks good with your, you know, your Gamera, your Showa Gamera. This is also the Memorial Box Gamera, which is the same mold from, you know, the green one everyone seems to have. So, same figure. Here's the sizing up with Godzilla. And, yeah, he looks good with Godzilla, too. So, your typical Bandai 6-inch figure. Nothing, you know, too crazy. So, yeah, now here's the card. As you can see, it's just, you know, your typical one-sheet card. It's actually more like a tag, whereas the Godzilla Memorial Box figures were more like just a card. This is more like a tag. So, it's a little more unique in that aspect. I got a picture of the, you know, the poster, what you call it. Let me get a little closer here. So, yeah, there's the, tag a little up more up close. Made in 99, apparently. Looks pretty neat. Got Gamera, Zigra, yeah. Okay. Now, back to the figure itself. I already showed you how tall it is. Now this guy, he obviously does not have, you know, he's not much in the way of articulation. It's just really just, you know, the tail. It just kind of does that. But really, you know, you don't expect any articulation from Zigra at all, so that's kind of, you know, another thing to nitpick. The head has a glue seal, and while you can break it and kind of twist his head from side to side a little bit, you know, that's, you know, not important. Fins, also separate piece. You can't really move them. But what you can do is pop them out and put them in different sides, so since they're curved this way, when you put them in the opposite side, it's much more flat. But that's, you know, it's really, you know, tiny detail, not important. So articulation, obviously, you know, not important on this guy, so I'm just going to go ahead and, you know, let that slide. Because, you know, what are you going to do? He's a shark character thing. You know, he's a thing from space, and he's a shark, so what are you going to do? Okay, now, the paint job, as you can see, Zigra is just more like, you know, silver all over. He's actually, you know, the blue vinyl with silver paint. And I like the way it's applied. It looks a little, you know, sporadic or random, you know, in things like the face. But it looks totally fine otherwise. Like, that kind of adds to it. Because, you know, it has a, you know, spray here. Spray in the front. Some of the fins right there. And, of course, a little on the back. So, it might look a little weird at first, you know, from this angle. But it's totally fine in person, and got a little in the head, so, you know, he looks really good, that's what I like. It looks, you know, really silvery and shiny, kind of like the suit did. The original Bandai one, it's more of a purplish color, actually. But, yeah. We're just talking about this one, and this one looks much better, I think. So, yeah, he's got, you know, other little touches like red for the eyes and whatnot, but really, he's just, you know, three colors. Red, silver, and blue. So, yeah, that's basically it. Now, let's get to the detail for this guy. Now, Zigra, despite seeming like, you know, a really simple character, the figure is actually very well detailed. The head looks kind of plain, you know, I mean, you've got some wrinkles in the face. But it's really when you get down here to the wrinkles in the body and the fins that it just really stands out and comes to life. You got the legs here, they look, you know, they got the boots, you know, kind of goofy, but that's, you know, that's kind of the charm of the suit. And, you know, when you make the transition from suit to figure, little details like keeping the boots is, you know, part of what makes it unique. And you got the fins, they look great, they look like, you know, kind of like a costume, really. Again, the body. And the mouth, you know, the mouth not too special, it's just kind of a closed beak. But he's got his little gem there for the, you know, the paralysis ray or whatever. So, yeah, he looks really nice. I like the way they did with the tail. They kind of, you know, flattened it this part so it can be level on the ground and still look kind of convincing. So, yeah, Zigra, very good, you know, very nice figure. So I haven't really talked much about the figure, you know, in, you know, kind of a more broad sense. Really, as I feel, you know, this, you know, Mormok Zigra, it's a really nice figure. Like, you're really not going to find much better. You could get the tiny Exos one, but that's pretty hard to find, and it's really just him in a swimming pose. So if you just want, you know, kind of a basic Zigra figure, this is the one to get. The new one, well, not the new one, the old one, I'm sorry. It's, you know, it's a nice figure of what it is. It's definitely bigger, and it, you know, it actually has fins for legs, as opposed to, you know, the boots here. But it's really just up to taste, and I still think, you know, this one is just tops. So if you're looking for, you know, this Zigra and you want to pick it up, you can probably find it at Tempting Toys. You know, maybe a few other places. It's, you know, not as common as your typical Bandai figure, obviously. But if you do get it, I'd say get it for no more than $40 at most with the tag. That's about as much as you want to pay for this, because it's a really nice figure, but for what you're getting, $40 is, you know, asking a bit much. You know, $20 to $30 range is about where you want to stay. Probably, you know, excluding shipping, because obviously shipping, you know, is gonna vary. But you want around that price range. So Zigra, definitely a big buy. If you're a Gamer fan, you're obviously going to want to pick this guy up. If you've got Zilla fan, you think he looks cool, and you're not too into the Gamera monsters, I say give this guy a try. I think he'll surprise you. I wasn't, you know, too big into Zigra. I was like, oh, he's a shark. Ooh, big deal. I got the figure in hand because I wanted to try out something different. I was like, you know what? This guy's really neat. I like him. So I say give Zigra a try. He's a really nice figure. Gonna have to give him a 4 to 5. The only thing really hurting this figure is the slight size, you know, problem. But that's not really a problem. It's just a preference. Slight size thing. And the lack of articulation, but again, that's just preference, you know. You know, a better rotating head would have been nice, but that's, you know, just a small thing. So while not perfect, this guy's pretty great. Okay, that's the review, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'll see you later.
You come to me and ask me to kill a man I do not know. Now I ask you, why should I kill this Count Chocula?
Because that son of a bitch has been spreading lies. My cereal does not cut the roof of your mouth. With all respect.